I know. When fractions show up, it's never a fun day, especially when they show up in your exponents. But don't you worry, we're going to cover everything about fractional exponents today on MathHacks. Fractional or rational exponents is just an alternate notation to express radicals like square roots, cube roots, fourth roots, and powers on those radicals. I'm going to show you exactly what that means in a few examples. When working with fractional exponents, we have a tiny bit new notation to learn. Now we still have our base number here in this example, which is 8. We still have a power. Now technically the power is the entire 2/3 now, but within that 2/3 we kind of have two new parts. We have the numerator, in this case the 2, and the denominator, in this case the 3. Now the 2 behaves like the normal power that you're used to, and it will square the number. So 8 is still being squared. Now the difference here is that the denominator adds a new part to our number. It adds a radical, and this radical has the index of whatever the denominator is. So for this example here, the index of the root is 3, so that means that I have a cube root. So 8 to the 2/3 power is really just the same as 8 squared inside a cube root. I can choose to write the squared either directly on the 8 or outside of the cube root. Whether you use this notation or this notation is up to your personal preference for an extent, and also sometimes your problem is just a little easier to work with in one notation or the other. For example, let's go ahead and simplify this. Now I have the choice of either squaring the 8 first and then taking the cube root, or I can take the cube root of 8 first and then square. Again, they're going to come out exactly the same, so it doesn't really matter which way I start, but I do think it's easier if you're doing mental math to take the cube root of 8 first, since that's 2, and then square it to get us to 4, versus the other way, which would be to square 8 and have 64, and then you need to know that the cube root of 64 is 4. Again, maybe that's common knowledge to you and seems really easy as well. Either way is totally fine. All right, in the second problem, we have 2 raised to the 5/4 power. So that means that I have 2 being raised to the 5th power, as well as a 4th root being applied to it. I could go directly into the radical notation and then try to simplify this, but sometimes working with these fractions is really handy. So I'm going to show you how we could simplify this with just using this fractional exponent first, and it might give you a nice idea of some alternate techniques you can use to simplify these problems. All right, so the first thing I did here was just took the improper fraction of 5/4 and rewrote it as the mixed number 1 1/4. Now this is really handy because 1 1/4 is the same as 1 1/4. And you'll see in a second why that's a nice thing to have. So you may remember from our exponent rules that if I have 2 numbers with the same base, I add their exponents. So I could do the exact reverse of that, and I could split this into 2 separate 2s being multiplied together, one with an exponent of 1 and the other with an exponent of 1/4. And then I have simplified this really nicely because I can go ahead and lose the power of 1 on the 2, and then I can go ahead and rewrite it in radical notation to clean this up a bit. There you go, and again, I don't need to write the powers of 1 because they're implied, so I just get 2 times the 4th root of 2. Nice and simplified. Again, we could have done that going directly to radical notation, and why don't I just show you that, because really either method is about the same amount of work, and it just depends on what clicks with your brain. So the other option is I could have started with this and immediately rewrote it as the 4th root of 2 to the 5th. And then from there, I know that every group of 4 will reduce. So because I have 5 2s multiplied together, I'm going to split out a group of 4 of those. So that gives me 2 to the 4th times 2 to the 1st underneath this radical. And of course, I can split this into 2 separate radicals and simplify. So then I get 2 times the 4th root of 2, which is exactly what we had in this situation. Here we've introduced variables just to make it a little more difficult. And I'm also going to show you in this problem how you can take a radical and change it into a fractional exponent to easily simplify it. So the first step here is to get rid of this cube root. And we can remember from our first problem up here that the denominator of 3 indicated a cube root. So I'm just going to trade this out for a power of 1/3. It's really important here to remember to keep parentheses around everything that was inside of the radical symbol, because I want that power to be applied to everything. If I didn't write this parenthesis, I could easily mistake the 1/3 power just on the y instead of on the x and y. From here, we are free to just use our exponent rule that says when we have a power raised to a power, we multiply. So I'm going to multiply 3 times 1/3 for the new power on the x, and I'm going to multiply 6 times 1/3 to get the new power on the y. There I get x to the 1st, y squared. Of course, I don't need to write this power of 1, so this can be rewritten as just x, y squared. In this one, we have a 5th root, and we have some powers that are going to be a little trickier to work with. So this is just a slightly more difficult problem than the last one. Again, I'm going to start the same way and replace this 5th root with a 1/5 power this time, since I want the index of the root to be 5. Once again, I'm going to multiply the 1/5 with the powers on a and b. And here I can use this same technique that we used in problem 2, where I took the improper fractions and just split it out into mixed numbers to pull out the whole number coefficient. So because 6/5 and 7/5 are both improper fractions, we can just use that exact same technique. My final step is just to clean this up a little bit. I'm gonna pull this a and b into the front, and I can drop the powers of 1 on them since that is implied. The other a and b can now be put back under a 5th root power since they both have exponents with denominators of 5. The only difference is that this a is going to be raised to the 1st power underneath the radical, whereas this b is going to be raised to the 2nd power under the radical. In this final problem, we're going to multiply these 2 cube roots together. Now, I have the option of either multiplying them together first and combining them into 1 cube root, or trading out the cube roots for powers of 1/3 before multiplying. I personally think it's easier to combine them into 1 cube root before I introduce that fractional exponent, so that's where I'm going to start. And now a squared times a to the 4th gives me a to the 6th. And b times b is simply b squared. Now let's go ahead and trade out this cube root for the 1/3 power. Then we can go ahead and multiply the 1/3 power through. When we do that, we get a squared times b to the 2/3. So the a squared has now lost the radical since I've gotten rid of the fraction in the exponent. And the b can be rewritten back in a cube root since I have this divide by 3 in the exponent. And you just want to make sure not to forget to write that power of 2 back on the b when you transcribe it. As always, there are 2 really easy things you can do to show your support for Math Hacks and keep more tutorials coming your way. 1, click that subscribe button if you haven't already. I don't know what you're waiting for. 2, give this video a big thumbs up to let everyone know how awesome it was. Well, that's all I have. See you guys next time.